Hi, my name's Kareem. I'm the IT community manager at Rippling. I've been in the IT space for over 10 years. And we're having today, we'll be discussing how Rippling can help you manage your Mac devices effectively and securely. We have Tyler Colts here today from the IT solutions community. Tyler, can you introduce yourself?
Yeah, thanks for joining, everyone. Like Kareem said, my name is Tyler, and I'm a senior IT solution consultant here at Rippling. For joining Rippling about 2 years ago, I worked at Jump Cloud, if you're familiar with them, for about 7 years in lots of different roles. So, looking forward to the conversation. Hopefully, we can teach you all a little bit about how Rippling works for Macs.
Awesome. Thanks, Tyler. Well, we have a range of topics to cover, so let's dive in. So, Tyler, first question, to start, what features does Rippling offer that differentiate it from other MDMs out there?
Yeah, I think there's two primary things to talk about here. One of them is just the way that Rippling is built upon your employee information. You'll probably see some marketing materials where we call it the employee graph, but think of it as an incredibly rich employee profile that's not just your department or who your manager is. It's thousands of attributes and relationships on which we build permission profiles, different kinds of automations and even reports. So using this really rich database of employees allows you to build a lot of different automations for IT, making sure that people have the right applications, making sure they get the right type of device and the right security policies on that device. But to bring this a little closer to like the Mac admins community, I think there's two specific features that nobody else does. Number one, Rippling is actually a reseller of devices here in the US and Canada. So when you hire somebody, you can say, let's give a MacBook Pro to my engineering team and a MacBook Air to my marketing team. And we can send it right to their door, or we can send it right to an office location, depending on where it needs to show up. And it's got all the same zero touch provisioning services that you're, I'm sure, familiar with in the space. And on the flip side of this, we can also help retrieve and store your devices. So really thinking about like the logistics of how you get hardware to people, in addition to all of the actual security policies that you would want to enforce on the device. So I'm sure we'll talk more about, specific security settings, but those are the two things that come to mind, in particular for, what sets Rippling apart.
Thanks, Tyler. Yeah, it seems like Rippling can totally help manage the full life cycle management of devices.
Yeah, 100%.
Cool. I'll move on to the next question. What device types can Rippling manage?
Yeah, so at the moment, we are both a Mac and a Windows MDM. We're really going to treat them the same way, both in the procurement and delivery and retrieval of devices that I mentioned before, but also in the administration of these devices. And soon enough, today is July 2nd, so you can keep us honest, but soon enough, we'll also support iOS. And iPadOS will be the next big, feature release for new device support types. That makes sense.
Awesome. We're going to move on to device management and security. So, how does Rippling handle the migration of devices from another MDM?
Yeah, there's different ways that you can go about this. Most of it is going to just be identifying, is this device enrolled in DEP through another MDM provider, or is it more of a greenfield implementation? There's some drawbacks to DEP enrolled devices where you actually will have to wipe them no matter which MDM that you are talking to re-enroll them in DEP, and we can't really help with that. But when it comes to the deployment of net new computers, we will automatically have that agent installed. And if you are removing another MDM from the device, we will give you a couple of different options. You can invite your employees to download the enrollment profile themselves, or you can simply send them the link to grab it from a central repository. So you'll just follow the instructions for whatever your MDM tells you to remove the previous one. Very simple from there to install the Rippling agent in just a few clicks.
Awesome. And what is the experience for enrolling new devices into Rippling?
You get the enrollment profile, and that is it. Once you've gotten the enrollment profile on the device, Rippling will automatically download the agent from there. And as long as things like, file vaults are already configured on the device or there's a secure token user, then it will show up in your asset list inside of Rippling, assigned to the right person, and begin building the profile from there. So very light touch in the actual, enrollment process and then user experience.
Awesome. Seems really straightforward. And move on to the next question. What kinds of policies can I enforce on my fleet using Rippling?
There's a baseline set of configurations and policies that most companies are going to want to deploy. Things like device encryption. Rippling will not only enforce file vault encryption, but store that recovery key in escrow. And we can enforce OS update policies, when these are visible to your employees, and when we'll actually force them to go through an upgrade to that latest version. We manage local accounts on your devices, so things like password policies will be present as well. And from there, it's really up to you, right? There's, I think, more than 100 pre-built configurations that exist inside of Rippling to restrict things like iCloud, to block USB storage from being plugged in, or to turn on different kinds of Wi-Fi or connect to a VPN, like turning on the firewall. So the list is too big, but I think the primary methods are the kind of your basic settings that we touched on up front, that huge list of pre-built configurations, and then the flexibility to add your own custom config profiles or deploy your own scripts, things like Bash.
Awesome. Awesome. That's super helpful putting in those baseline security features to secure your fleet. So moving on to the next question, you kind of touched a little bit about it in the last answer, your last answer to my question. What is the macOS update experience with Rippling? This is always a touchy subject with a lot of MDMs. What is that experience like with Rippling?
Yeah, so you get to set when a update becomes visible to your employees, and then from the date that it becomes visible, when they will actually have to go through an upgrade. And it's a pretty standard experience that you'll get on most MDMs here, where there's a pop-up, like the push notification on the device, that will tell your employee, number one, like you have to restart your computer at some point in the next week, and we'll keep trying. In the afternoons, you'll get that 2-minute window. Like if you do nothing, your computer is going to restart and apply these policies. And if you are, outside of the enforcement window, eventually we will force you to restart your computer the next time that you log in. So you can defer it. We're not going to just ruin all of your work. If you're in a Zoom meeting or you're working on an important document, you'll be notified along the way. But eventually, you'll be forced to upgrade.
Cool. Sounds pretty straightforward. We're going to move on to the next question. And this one's pretty important. A lot of MDMs and other tools are integrating with SIEMs, EDRs. Can Rippling integrate with these security tools today?
Yeah, so obviously the way that we integrate with a SIEM versus an EDR would be different, but we have what we call our activity log, and this tracks who's signing into a device, where did they sign in from, for example, and you get very similar data in the identity and access management portion of our product as well. And these can be exposed to really any SIEM tool that you might be using through our API. There are some plans in the work to make like direct data streams with SIEM tools. So more, stay tuned, more to come on deeper integrations with these. But even as it stands today, you have the ability to extract this data programmatically to a SIEM. And on the EDR side of things, we have a partnership with SentinelOne in particular. So we're a reseller of SentinelOne. We make sure that it's actually installed on your fleet of devices, which oftentimes is the biggest challenge. And you also get a data stream where, as a threat is detected by SentinelOne, you can remediate it from the admin console in Rippling. If you're not using SentinelOne, totally fine. We can also deploy custom software to make sure that, Sophos or Bitdefender or whatever tool it happens to be is present across all of your devices, just kind of a special relationship with SentinelOne in particular.
That's awesome. Didn't know about that ability to remediate issues directly within the console. That's really awesome, and definitely really cool, and sets out a differentiator between other products. Last question on device management and security. How does Rippling manage app updates?
Yeah, so this is I briefly mentioned this in like deploying other pieces of software, but there's I'd say three primary ways that Rippling can get software on your devices. We have a catalog of more than 100 apps. These are the most commonly used sorts of things like Slack or Zoom or Chrome. Big list, obviously. I won't rattle all of them off, but anything that's in that catalog of software from Rippling. We will not only install it, we will automatically keep it up to date without any end user involvement. So your most important apps will be protected by default. You could
That's
also
awesome.
deploy applications through VPP, at which point that's just going to be handled and on the Apple side of things and have you enforced auto updates. And you can also deploy custom software. If you're using CAD kind of tools are a very common example here, where you want to have a specific version of software that everybody is forced to use. You just upload the executable inside of Rippling, and that gives you full version control. You get to just re-upload, the next stable patch that you want to deploy to your devices. So three primary ways for the core ones, we keep it up to date automatically. If you're uploading custom software, then you've got full control to either script out auto updates or just do the version control manually.
Awesome. Thanks for that, Tyler. We're going to move on to user and access management. So, does Rippling allow admins to set different access levels on devices?
Yes. So there's the, and just to be clear, there's like the Rippling administrative side of things, and then there's, are you a local administrator on your device? So Rippling manages local accounts on your computer, and a Rippling administrator, like in our web console, gets to decide who by default is an admin. In many cases, like engineers or the information technology department, they're going to be local administrators by default, and everyone else will be a standard user. But we also give Rippling administrators the ability to temporarily elevate permissions for their employees on their device. So you could give 30 minutes of admin rights, and then we would automatically revert you back to a standard user, or you can empower your employees to self-promote on Mac. So I'm always a standard user on my device, but as you can imagine, I have to do admin stuff all the time in my job. So I open up the Rippling agent on my computer, I click enable admin rights, and for 30 minutes, I'm an administrator. So different ways to do this, a top-down approach or allowing your employees to, raise their hand and become an admin to do particular tasks.
Awesome. Thank you, Tyler. Does Rippling support platform SSL for Mac users? So, can I sign into the device with my Rippling account credentials today?
At the moment, we've got a different pat like a device specific password that you're going to set for Macs. But one of the things we're really excited about that's in development is exactly what you said. Platform SSL is what we're calling it, where you could use just any identity provider, Rippling as the IDP or Okta or Azure credentials to sign in to an actual device. It'll still be a local account under the covers with cached credentials in case you're offline. But we are building this in sometime in the second half of the year. I don't want to promise exact timelines here, but it's in active development. So very excited.
Yeah, that sounds really, really exciting. Moving on, we're going to be talking about monitoring reporting a little bit. You kind of briefly touched about it about when we asked the question about SIM and the activity and monitoring. Can you speak a little bit more about what are the Rippling's monitoring and reporting capabilities for managing Macs?
Yeah, and the joke that I make oftentimes on calls is Rippling is not Big Brother. We're not looking at keystrokes, like we can't see all of your web activity, but we're Little Brother. We've got some hooks to look into what kind of software is installed on the device, what version that software is, and then the authentication events that I was mentioning before. And a lot of the other monitoring activities that you might want to do, like pulling logs from the agent or, extracting well, any number of things. These are possible through either scripts that you can execute inside of Rippling, or configuration policies that would, potentially block access to certain kinds of websites, like a content filter. So it's always walking that fine line, right? We don't want to spy on your employees. We have none of those capabilities built in natively, but keeping track of where people are signing in from, what's on their device, and blocking them from accessing things they should not on the internet is that's the common scenario.
Yeah, totally. And it's all, I think, best practice for security individuals and standards out here. And this kind of leads to my next question a little bit. How can Rippling help me with my compliance initiatives and goals?
Yeah, so taking something like SOC 2 or ISO compliance as a core example, you set a lot of the policies. Like, it's up to your team to decide many of these different settings, and then you have to adhere to it. But Rippling makes enforcing these policies quite easy. So, like, access control policies for web applications on the device side of things, really just ensuring encryption that your devices are up to a certain OS standard. You can report on really anything that's built inside of Rippling. We've got very easy dashboards. So at a glance, you can see, do I have any devices that are currently unencrypted, for example? But you can generate fully custom reports that cross-references not just your device data, but it collates it with employee data. So, like, how old are my devices? And are older devices in a worse state when it comes to security? That kind of thing. And we do also have integrations with compliance tools like Trotta, like Vanta, where we can very easily transmit data about not only the employee, but their devices as well. So exactly what your compliance story is will vary, but Rippling can enforce these policies and help you report on anything that you've built in our system.
Awesome. That's phenomenal. Definitely seems like you can help a lot of companies achieve these goals. So on to the last question. You kind of briefly touched about it by mentioning integrations with Drata. What other integrations does Rippling have with IT tools that are out there in the market, or common
Yeah.
IT tools that are used in the market?
Yeah, definitely. There's so many, right? Rippling tries to take a very open approach to integrations with other tools. So while we are an identity provider ourselves, you may have spent months, if not years, building out your Okta environment or building out your Entra environment for identity. So very seamless integrations with, the majority of the larger identity providers in the space. Tools like Vanta and Drata and Steamboat that are more around compliance. We have bespoke integrations in the app shop that actually transfer data about your, Rippling employees to these different services. And we already touched some of this on the EDR side of things or SIM tools, but pretty much any tool that exists in the market, you can get some piece of data from Rippling over into a different tool. Many of these are pre-built integrations, but there's also a lot of custom work that we can do to integrate with whatever is in your tech stack at the moment.
Awesome. Well, that concludes our Q&A session. And thank you everyone for joining today. If you have any further questions or need any additional information, please don't hesitate to reach out in the Rippling Mac Admins channel. Thanks, Tyler.
Yeah, thank you, Kareem. Thanks, everyone.